Welcome to the Daksha Masterclass Recap. India has the second largest telecommunications network in the world, with the number of telephone users at 1.17 billion. As a lawyer, aren't you interested in understanding the telecommunications laws that govern our country? Here is a detailed and concise explanation on the Indian Telegraph Act of 1885, the Indian Wireless Act of 1993, by our visiting faculty, Nikhil Narendran. Listen in to the Daksha Masterclass on Telecom Law and Policy.
The first one being the Indian Telegraph Act of 1885. This colonial era registration is even governing us as of now. And the reason why it's governing us is because of the definition of telegraph, which is a very wide definition, which is futuristic enough or future-proof enough to cover most modern equipment which deals with communication. Similarly, we also had an Indian Telegraph Act sometime in 1933, which dealt with wireless telegraph. So I was mentioning about the definition of telegraph under the Indian Telegraph Act. So as I said, it's a very wide definition that you can see on your screens. It means any appliance, instrument, etc., which is capable of transmission or reception of signals, writings, images, etc., which is using electromagnetic waves, radio waves, Hertzian waves, galvanic waves, etc., etc. So any equipment that you use, even your modern age computer, laptops, or mobile phones could fall under the definition of a Telegraph Act if it's used for this purpose of transmitting messages using cables, right? And what government had was the government had an exclusive privilege or a monopoly of establishing, maintaining, and working telegraphs within India. And later there was a provision that was introduced which said that the government could also grant a license and part with its sovereign right to operate a telegraph to a private. And it is using this license that most companies in India currently are operating their telephone networks. In fact, it is using this particular provision or exemption that the public at large, including us, are using the telephones or mobile phones that we have. The only difference being that the equipments which are used by public at large have been delicensed by the government by way of a general exemption, whereas when you operate a telecom network as a company, you are essentially given a limited right to operate that with under a specific license. Similarly, moving on to the Wireless Telegraph Act, the definition there as well is very wide. It covers any instrument or material which is used for wireless communication. The initial use, of course, was to use a regular wireless telegraph, but the definition itself is future-proof to cover any equipment which transmits using electronic waves or what you call as spectrum. The key difference that one should note between the two licensing requirements under these two acts. So telegraph specifically dealt with establishing, maintaining, and operating of a telegraph, whereas Wireless Telegraph Act dealt only with possession. I think it should be wrong to say it's wrong to say that it only deals with possession, because the essential understanding is that one needs a permission under both Telegraph Act and Wireless Telegraphy Act to operate a telegraph. So you need these twin permission to operate a wireless telegraph, such as an antenna which is used by a telecom company for transmission. The interesting thing here is the possession requirement under the Wireless Telegraphy Act was very, very recently, very strictly regulated in the sense that even if you were to use a radio apparatus, you were supposed to take a possession license from the government of India, without which you could not use it for receiving radio communication, which was later delicensed by the government. So even your Wi-Fi equipment that you have at your homes, it operates in a particular frequency of 2.4 gigahertz. So 2.4 gigahertz, if you want to operate in that, till 10 years, 15 years back, it was regulated or licensed by the government. Then the government came out with a notification specifically delicensing certain frequency. Even currently, a large number of frequencies are delicensed, licensed. Some of the delicensed frequencies that we come across fairly regularly is one is one is RFID, the radio frequency identification. That's a frequency which is relicensed. Another one that we use commonly these days is Bluetooth, which was also licensed later. The 5 gigahertz spectrum, if you use a dual band Wi-Fi at your home, is also a delicensed frequency. Whereas a large number of ones still remain very under the strict regulation of the government. Some of these appliances that you use, you would have used some of these chargers for your laptops and computers, they also used to be regulated because they also used to provide produce some sort of frequency. Those frequencies has also been delicensed by the government in the recent years.